It's a pleasure and an honor to be invited to co-edit the special issue of Translational Urology and Andrology with Dr. Philip Shuali. This is an exciting, cutting-edge issue that's devoted to the leading new developments in our field. It's going to be coming out with information that won't appear in the major textbooks such as Campbell's Urology or Glenn's Urology for 3 or 4 years, and it's going to be coming out now. Some of the leading edge developments that we'll be presenting here are the use of Raman mass spectroscopy, multiphoton microscopy for the identification of live sperm inside the testicle during testicular microdissection procedures, and for the identification of nerves in the spermatic cord, which would be very helpful in denervation procedures for the large number of men who have chronic orchialgia. Some of the other things that we'll be addressing are the influence of metabolic syndrome, which is incredibly common worldwide and especially in the United States, which has been shown to be a contributor to androgen deficiency. We'll also be looking at treatments for androgen deficiency, not just replacement with testosterone, but treating conditions that cause low testosterone, one of which is varicocele, which traditionally has been limited to repair for the treatment of male infertility, but has now been shown to be a major cause of not just infertility, but low testosterone, and treating it will increase not just fertility, but also increase testosterone levels, allowing men to make their own sperm. This is particularly important in men for whom future fertility is still an issue, where giving testosterone is not an option, because we know testosterone suppresses spermatogenesis in men. Some of the other things that will be discussed in this special issue are some of the advanced new microsurgical techniques for repair of epididymal obstruction, the success rates of which have steadily increased with the introduction of the intussusception techniques for the repair of epididymal obstruction, newer techniques for repairing of vasal obstruction, use of robotic techniques for freeing up the vas in men that have infertility and azoospermia due to mesh repair of inguinal hernias, which is an incredibly common cause of obstructive azoospermia. One of the other exciting new developments is a study of a new device called the Shang ring, which will enable us to facilitate the rollout of circumcisions in men. In Africa, this has been shown to reduce significantly the transmission of the human papillomavirus, the HIV virus, which is the cause of AIDS, and HSV, the cause of herpes, which then causes lesions which make men more susceptible to getting HIV or HPV, the human papillomavirus, which is the main cause of cervical cancer in women and venereal warts in men and women. This device simplifies circumcision, allows it to be done by non-physician, non-surgeons, without requiring sutures, can be done in somewhere between 3 and 5 minutes, and will enable circumcisions to be done on a large scale. This study has been funded by the Gates Foundation, which is very enthusiastic about supporting the use of this device and supporting the use of circumcision around the world for the reduction of these sexually transmitted diseases. Overall, this issue is one of the most exciting new compendiums of advances in the field of andrology, microsurgery, and men's health. And I'm excited to be and honored to be part of this effort.